Very much. Well, if you consider yourself a cookie monster, you are in the right place. How would you like a different feature cookie every month? Well, I'm joined by Andrea Green, founder of the Connecticut Cookie Company, who's doing exactly that. Thank you for joining
Thanks
us
for
so early
me,
this morning. And
so
thank
exciting.
You for bringing all these cookies.
Yeah.
A cookie of the month. Now, this is not like, you know, the fruit of the month club, but you've got to come up with a different recipe. Are they, you know, do you have ingredients that are specific for the season, or how do you decide what cookie is good for what month?
Well, first, I try to use my grandma's old recipes, but some of them have shortening.
Okay.
So I switch out of the shortening, switch for to no, butter.
Why not shortening?
Well, I just feel like just bad for your heart.
Oh, okay.
Actually, no, that's,
all right.
Yeah, not good for, so
right.
Use more butter as my preservative. And I try to use no more than 7 ingredients because I want my recipes to be simple,
oh,
not too
right.
complicated. Some actually are only 4 that you'll see out here.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, so simple is better.
All right. So you tap in grandma's experience for some
yep.
of these recipes. Walk me around what we've got here.
Yeah.
What are some of the examples we're talking
about?
Yeah,
well, I also use my mother-in-law's. She's a great baker. So actually, starting off with hers is the thumb raspberry jam print.
Mm.
It's actually like a giant thumb print, but it's a very light shortbread cookie.
Okay.
And then try
Looks
to use
like
seasonal.
A little Danish to me there. Yeah,
yeah, it does. So seasonal. So July, I might try blueberries.
Okay, so whatever kind of thing is
yeah,
in season,
yeah.
whatever fruit is in season, you
yep.
can put that in there. All right.
Yeah, and
got
that's
it.
A simple recipe, only 5 ingredients.
All
there.
Right.
And then the classics, the chocolate chunk cookie. Actually, I grind in some dark chocolate in that cookie, so you get
Ooh.
A so it's a little healthier. And then everyone keeps asking me about peanut butter cookies. So I've been trying peanut butter cookies.
Mm-hmm.
That's my favorite, actually. And I'm more of a savory, salty person. So
okay, all right.
And then
that works.
My husband's idea was to try the chocolate chunk with some toffee. So that's what you see here.
Oh.
So a little bit of toffee. And these all are simple recipes, actually, too. And then the most popular is the quick fix. This is a dark chocolate with almonds, sea salt, and a graham cracker bottom. And so it's that salty,
mm.
savory, and we called it the quick fix because you can't get enough of it. And we even put it in the freezer.
Okay.
My mother-in-law was like, I can't stop eating it. So she and I named it the quick fix because it's like an addiction.
Yeah.
And then moving on, like snickerdoodles. So many people kept asking me, like, are you going to do snickerdoodles? So I think we're going to kick off for the cookie of the month for September will be snickerdoodles. It's
All
like
right.
a classic old school cookie.
Mm.
And then moving on to kids love the sugar cookie, and actually I only use a quarter cup of sugar for the cookies.
Well, I was looking at that. We think about that for the holidays, but that could be
yeah,
like a 4th of
yeah,
July
exactly.
or a Memorial
yeah,
Day sort of
yeah.
thing too.
Yeah, we call it the sugar rush, even though there's a little bit, not as much sugar as most cut out
right.
cookies.
Yep.
And then if you had the icing too.
Yep.
And then these are the chocolate with white chocolate chunks, because a lot of people were like, we love chocolate based cookies, not just
sure.
chocolate chips.
Oh,
so
yeah.
with white chocolate, so you get a little
Yep,
chunky.
A little variety in there too.
Yeah. Yeah, not too heavy, not too sweet. And
yep.
then the coconut macaroons, actually, these are a classic. This is only 4 ingredients, and it actually contains no wheat. So mm. that's what a lot of people who are gluten-free will try the coconut macaroons, and it's all okay. using my grandma's hometown vanilla.
Yeah, now tell me about that. What is up with that? The special vanilla?
Yeah, well, this is from Indiana, and it's a pharmacy that's been around. I don't even know how long it's been around, but it's been around, and they have the pharmacy, and then they sell the vanilla. And they could literally just sell the vanilla. They're so busy. And I buy it in gallons, and it's been around. And they use old medicine bottles to...
It's kind of your secret ingredient.
Yeah, yeah,
there,
oh, that's the secret ingredient.
The special
yeah,
Indiana
for sure.
vanilla.
Yeah, 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 all the way from Indiana.
Now, if people are looking at these saying, oh, I got to have me some of those, how do they get in touch with you? You have a store?
Oh,
or are
no,
you doing
one
this
day.
Online? Or what are
yeah,
you doing?
Right now my website is my storefront. So
okay.
it's ctcoco.com, ctcoco.com.
All right.
So you go to the website and you'll start seeing, you can sign up and start to get cookie of the month. And then if you order for out the year, we're going to give special surprises and deals for out the year. And then getting ready, people are asking me now for the holidays too.
Sure.
Like, what can I
oh,
order for my company? I want to give out gifts. I want to.
Okay.
I'm buying a new home, and or I have friends who are realtors. Like, I'm buying it.
And these get shipped right to your home.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can
all
order
right.
as much as you want.
All right. Now
yeah.
you just got to get some milk shipped to you too,
yeah,
and you're
yeah,
all set
yeah.
for
milk
a
and
nice
cookies. Perfect.
A
How
nice
classic.
Afternoon.
Nice.
All
and
right.
Simple.
Well, thank you very much, Andrea Green, founder of the Connecticut Cookie Company. If you want to find out more, you can log on to our website, WTNH.com. You just click on the Good Morning Connecticut Weekend section for that.